Assalamualaikum and hi students. So I would like to deliver next lesson about chapter number 3. This is actually slide number 9. Okay. So basic component of fungal cell wall again. As you can see from here, there actually a primary wall and a secondary wall. Okay, down there is a primary wall. Meanwhile, for the upper layer, this is a secondary wall. And in detail, if you look at slide, you know, for the primary wall, you can see, you can find out, okay, chitin, okay, plasma membrane, cytoplasm, chitin, beta glucans. Okay, meanwhile for the secondary wall, you can see from here menapotrins. Okay, so this is actually a characteristic of fungal cell, or the characteristic or the what you can see through the fungal cell and its component, and also the benefit. Okay, so of course fungal cell wall gives shape to fungi, number one. Number two, gives strength to the fungi. Of course it can make the fungi strong, I mean the strength component. Number three, provides protection for the protoplasm from ultraviolet rays present of melanin. Okay, melanin is actually a type of color, or type of color or pigment, okay, in something like our skin. Okay, next, ability to resist lysis by organic solvents such as enzymes, toxins, osmotic and integrity. Next one, ability to bind with metal ions. And last one, they also secret enzymes from their walls, interface hydrolysis sucrose to glucose and fructose, for example, and so assisting in nutrition. Okay, again, I told you before, you must, this is about chemical component composition of the wall. Okay, the cell wall is made up of polymeric fibrils. Okay, of course, they are actually a component of chitin. Okay, polymers of acetylated amino acid and acetylglucosamine. Okay, and amorphous matrix components, which are number one, glucans, polymers of glucose. Number two, protein, polymers of amino acids, lipids. And the last one is heteropolymers. This is mixed polymers of mannose, galactose, and etc. So these types of amount of various components, vary amounts, difference group. Okay, it means different. This component is actually depends on type of fungus. Okay, again, as I told you before, about the structure of the cell wall. Okay, this is very detailed. So please take a look and please do recall and remember this type of structure, because very, very, very important component. For example, if you look as you can see from here, from your right hand side, okay, this is a glycoprotein. Okay, so followed by glucan, chitosan, cell membrane, structural polysaccharide, anamorphous matrix, and surface coat. And down there also, I think the same thing, on the protein, chitin, membrane protein, cell membrane, and beta glucan. They are actually different, as I told you before, different fungus, they have their own main different ones. So that's why they are different here. See, now it's actually again the same thing about arrangement of the cell wall. As you can see from here, the same thing, okay, but I think this is a different type of fungus, but this is again arrangement of cell wall. Okay, from the upper layer, amorphous glucans, okay, as we have learned before, glycoprotein plus protein, and the last one, chitin plus protein, and lower layer is a plasma membrane. So in general, the inner part of the cell wall consists of polymeric fibrils embedded in a amorphous matrix and discovered by further layers of matrix material. Okay, this is something like, you know, I think you have learned about matrix component. At the hypotips, the wall is thicker, thinner, and simpler in structure, consisting of two layers, which are inner layer of fibril embedded in protein and outer layer of mainly protein. And extra layers is actually a wall, okay, material deposited in the layer walls behind the extending apex, strengthening the walls, the wall of the hypermatures. Okay, the in the older parts of hypa and in many fungal spores, there are lipids and pigments maybe deposited in the wall. Lipids serve as nutrients serve and help prevent desiccation. There are pigments, okay, such as a melanin. I told you before, this is a pigment, a color, okay, help protect the protoplast against the damaging effect of UV radiation. And again, as you can see from here, this is a table, common wall constituent found of each division of fungi, adapted from Goudet, Ingo, and Gett, 1995. Okay, so division, okay, different type of fungus, they have their own different type of fibrous and gel-like polymers. Okay, for example here, for Basidium mycota, okay, for fibrous, they are a chitin, beta-1-3, beta-1-6, and glucan. Meanwhile, for gel-like polymer, they are xylomanoproteins and alpha-1-3 glucan. Okay, for the rest, Ascomycota, Zygomycota, Cryptidiomycota. I think you may take a look, and this is a differences. Okay, from different type of fungus. Okay, we'll continue later on. Thank you.